the National Association of Software and Services Companies. Thank you to the President, Shri R. Chandrasekhar Garu, to the President Designate, Devjani Ghosh, a dear friend. Rohit Kapoor, thank you for flying all the way from New York. I hope you're over your jet lag. Srikanth, thank you for your amazing endorsement and for being there with us, because as an innovator, I think you've proved yourself, your mettle, and when we met 2 years ago till today, I think we've crossed a few barriers, and I'm delighted we're making a wonderful announcement today. So thank you very much for being part of this announcement. And thank you to all the media friends. Firstly, let me just quickly start from where Devjani has left off. She said, data is useless if you actually don't put it to good use. I completely agree with her, because there is this perennial 3V problem, 3V problem with data. The first V is volume. The volume with which data is created, and the speed, the kind of amount of data that is being created, is humongous. Every single day, we have terabytes and terabytes of data, and maybe, I don't know, what else is beyond terabyte, I don't know. Hexabytes of data being created. So the volume is huge, firstly. The second, variety. The variety of data. The data sets that get created and the different data forms that get created are huge again. The variations, the languages, the variations among the different systems, et cetera, in which data gets created is also huge. The third thing, velocity. The speed with which data is being created also is a huge, huge challenge for anybody who wants to actually make something out of data. Because as Devjani said, yes, we've heard it enough times, data is the new currency, data is the new oil, et cetera, we've heard it before. But to actually make something meaningful out of it, meaningful for your people, for your citizens, for your country, for your state, I think is extremely important that we leverage the amazing opportunities that we have around us. Now, just to give you numbers, it is estimated by NASSCOM and others that by 2025, we'll have $16 billion worth of opportunity, business opportunity, in AI and data sciences in India alone. In India alone. And this will create nearly 150,000 new jobs in these two specific fields, data sciences and AI. Now, I'm delighted with this partnership with NASSCOM, because it gives not only the country, like Devjani said, we should be thinking bigger. We should be having ambitions which are beyond our geographical boundaries of the state of Telangana. But at the same time, as a minister of Telangana, as a public representative in Telangana, I would be remiss if I do not also seize upon this opportunity to create large-scale employment in these specific fields for the children and for the students who are going to be graduating in the next 7-8 years. So the opportunity is there. The partnership has now just been signed. Now it is incumbent that government of Telangana takes it, along with the industry partnership, along with the industry partners, to make sure that our children, our students are equipped to seize this opportunity. Srikanth put it very, very succinctly. He said government is the biggest customer. Yes, absolutely. The government of Telangana, in fact, is possibly one of those governments which has already started leveraging data in a big way. We have, in fact, 38 crore worth of records in our system, which are seamlessly linked across multiple databases. The interoperability factor that many people talk about has been bridged to an extent. I would not say, I would not comment on the percentage of the success, but we've been able to travel that, begin that journey, not travel, but begin that journey. I would happily, in fact, share with Srikanth and the entire team of NASSCOM that government shall be your biggest customer. I assure you that. Because I think the value that we see, for instance, those of you who are wondering about how government can leverage this. In April this year, our chief minister, in fact, has decided to start farm input assistance or input support to our farmers, about nearly 5.5 million farmers, millions and millions of farmers across the state of Telangana, which is a revolutionary step. Now, how can the government leverage this? Once the farmer starts working, with the assistance given by the government, the 24 hours of power, adequate water supply, if there is a pest, for instance, as a problem statement, just to give you a problem statement, the farmer should not be running to the nearest agriculture extension officer or should not be running to the nearest scientist. All he should be able to do is take a phone, take a picture, send it to a specific number. I should be able to go back to him using AI and a combination of machine learning, which obviously is supported by data. We should be able to give that farmer a quick SMS saying, with 95% accuracy, I can tell you that this could be the pest. So this is a real world application of what can happen with a combination of data sciences, AI, and machine learning. In fact, we're proud as a state. We are the first state in India to have started leveraging AI for screening the eyes of our children in schools. With Microsoft as a partner, we have started a large-scale screening campaign of our children in the state of Telangana. Again, using AI, we are able to look at their eyes, we are able to screen their eyes, and are able to give them a report on whether or not they are likely to develop some disorder in the future. Predictive analytics, again, based on data and data sciences. So these are the real-world experiences, real-world examples of how you can leverage technologies. Let me also give you another example. For instance, in education, again, you can leverage a combination of all the above, again, to give high quality education to the student who desires it. Now, same is the case with law enforcement. For example, drunk driving is a big issue in today's world. Now, if a combination of all these different, technologies, for example, AI and machine learning can be embedded in a car, the car, in fact, can shut itself down if it realizes that a guy is drunk, because there is a certain pattern. In fact, AI and machine learning again, and data again, can help you. If you are a person in distress, man, woman, gender agnostic, if you are a person in distress, and if you're unable to speak, all you have to do is dial a certain number or just hit a button, and your voice modulation can be detected for stress, and a team can be sent to rescue you. The combination, the power of technology, the real world utilization of it is something that can only be envisioned, that can only be imagined. You're only limited by your imagination, literally. The possibilities are endless. I've shared with you three or four things where I think technologies can play a great role, and the possibilities where government can be the biggest customer. Law enforcement can be a customer, health department can be a customer, education can be a customer, agriculture can be a customer, mines department can be a customer, I can go on and on. Every single department in government. In fact, for those of you who already know, governments in fact are the largest data owners in the world. I think after Google and Facebook, Aadhaar is probably the third largest database in the world, as was pointed out by Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad yesterday. So the fact is government sits on a ton of data. What do you do with it? How do you leverage it? For example, a person applies for a 2 BHK program in the state of Telangana, for a house in the state of Telangana. How do you make sure that this person actually does not already own a house? You can use data. You can use a combination of the 38 crore records I mentioned to you. You can use certain keywords, see if he's already having a house, if he's already paying property tax, etc., etc. So these are amazing tools which will help governments govern better. This will help our country, in fact, create employment, seize the opportunity. Because people talk about emerging technologies as a threat to employment, which is a fallacy. In fact, as was pointed out by Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad yesterday, while there could be a few jobs which could become redundant, there could be hundreds more which could be created newly because of emerging technologies in a country like India. So therefore, I think this is a very, very exciting partnership from Government of Telangana's perspective. I'm delighted. NASSCOM, in fact, has been an excellent partner in the last 3.5 years. After this new state has come into being, as was pointed out, there could have been apprehensions about what would happen to Hyderabad and the technology industry here. But in the last 3.5 years, NASSCOM and several other industry players have invested big amount of faith and confidence in the state of Telangana and the city of Hyderabad. I'm delighted that they've actually brought NILF, the NASSCOM India Leadership Forum, which traditionally has happened for the last 25 years, without an exception, in Mumbai, for the first time, taking all these guys out of Mumbai and bringing them here this far, I mean, come on sir, too far, I was being facetious, of course, is in itself an achievement, right? And the second thing is, the kind of expertise NASSCOM has, you know, the kind of reports we look for them every single year on the industry trends, on emerging technologies, on how the landscape is changing, on the visa regime, on what is happening with immigration, et cetera, et cetera. They have been the leading light. They have been the torchbearer of the industry of millions and millions of young Indians. They look towards NASSCOM to give them direction. So I'm delighted that NASSCOM, in fact, Mr. Chandrasekhar, Devjani, and they're, you know, represented by the entire top leadership. I'm delighted they're here. And they've also not only invested faith in Hyderabad, they've created these centers of excellence across the country, and I'm delighted they've chosen two important subjects here, data sciences and AI, which I think are extremely important. So I couldn't be more happier. We'll just take this forward, like Jayesh said, one step at a time. But I assure you once again, sir and madam, that the government will be your biggest customer. We'll not only be your customer, but we'll also be your partner. So therefore, I look forward to a very fruitful partnership, and we look forward to taking this in a more robust fashion and providing solutions not just for Telangana, but also for the rest of the country. Thank you. Thank you for this opportunity.